சரிமா எனக்கு இந்த சார்ஜர் மட்டும் போட்டு தாய்
ரேகா வி கேன் ஹியர்
யூ ஓ சாரி சாரி ஐ அம் சாரி ஐ ஆக்சுவலி ஸ்டாப் தி வீடியோ
Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and esteemed guests. I welcome you all to the 747th meet of Chennai Toastmasters Club. The mission of every Toastmaster Club is to provide a supportive and a positive learning experience in such a way the members are empowered to improve their communication skills and their leadership qualities, hence resulting in greater personality growth and self-confidence. Before moving on to the meeting, I'd like to brief upon certain virtual equities before we could move on. Number one, kindly keep our mobile phones on silent mode, followed by do not talk about taboo topics such as sex, politics and religion. Kindly sit in a silent atmosphere so that you can hear what the speaker is speaking. If you have any queries to be passed on by, kindly drop it in the chat box below. And kindly please stay on mute until and unless if it is your turn to speak. At that moment, you can unmute yourself. And another small request is that if you are a role player, kindly put the role name hyphen followed by your name. For instance, if I am the EDM master for the day, I'll be mentioning myself as EDM master hyphen Toastmaster Aishwarya. And the same implies to guests as well. If you are a guest for this today's meeting, please rename yourself as guest hyphen followed by your name. And on this note, I would like to hand over the control to our presiding officer, Toastmaster Abhilash. Over to you.
Thank you. Mark Twain once said, "The secret of getting ahead is getting started." On that note, I would like to declare open meeting number 747. Before we move on, I would like to brief you all that our Area C1 contest happened yesterday, and Toastmaster Puneet from Chennai Toastmasters won the first place in evaluation, and Toastmaster Jagadish won the second place in the humorous contest, and they will be representing at the division level. Let us give a loud round of applause. Let us give a loud round of applause to both the contestants and wish them all the best. Thank you. Now, let me move on to introducing to you all the Toastmaster of the day. Today's Toastmaster of the day is a very passionate Toastmaster. Her age might be a little advanced, but at heart, I believe she is as young as each and every one of us, or probably as young as me. She's a very enthusiastic Toastmaster, and I have no doubt that today's meeting is going to be a cracker of a meeting. Without much ado, let me introduce you Toastmaster Geeta, the Toastmaster of the day. Toastmaster Geeta, the stage is yours.
Thank you, Toastmaster Abhilash. Let me tell you, I'm just in my 40s. I don't think that's old enough to be called a little ahead in age. But then,
so
yes.
You are as young as me. I am 23.
Yes. Thank you so much. Yeah. You know, because of this lockdown, I think we are not able to dye our hair and all. And that's how we look more old, I think. Yes. Good afternoon, everyone. I welcome you all for today's meeting. Trust me, Toastmasters. I was just reading the book, The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari. And I started getting messages on my chat. Madam, you are the Toastmaster of the day for the Sunday's meeting. Please give us a theme. They didn't give me they didn't give me time to think about a theme. So I decided to talk about the book, The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari by Robin Sharma. Trust me, Toastmasters, this is a very interesting book. To tell you something about the book, the story is about a lawyer who was rich and famous, and he had money and he could buy everything that he wished. He had a huge mansion. He had a red Ferrari, but then suddenly he had to go through he collapsed in his courtroom due to a heart attack. And this near-death experience brought about a turnaround in his life. So he went to the hills of Himalayas, and he learned from the sages of the Sivanas, very good life learning lessons, which he returns back and imparts it to his apprentice, John. So let's know a few of the learnings which have positively impacted me when I read this book. So
the first life lesson that I learned here is to cultivate a mind which is free of weeds. In short, we need to master our mind. So only here the mind has been, they have compared the mind to a garden. So just like you cultivate a garden, you need to cultivate your mind with positive thoughts. And once the mind is well cultivated and nurtured, then it will take you ahead in life and you will see all the happiness and you will blossom beyond your expectations. Isn't this something similar to our Toastmasters meeting? Toastmasters meeting also is a field where we all put in our efforts, our sincerity in taking up the roles. And the amount of or the quality of efforts that we put in will give us the desired results. That is, it will take us to being an effective communicator or an effective leader. So moving on to the meeting, let me introduce to you all the general evaluator of the evening. The general evaluator of the evening is Toastmaster Satish, who is going to have a quality check on the meetings. He is working with Kotak Mahindra and he is a savior today. He has accepted to take up the role in the last minute. Over to you, Toastmaster Satish. Would you please brief your responsibilities as the general evaluator for today's meeting?
Thank you so much, ma'am, for the wonderful introduction. Good evening, all. This is Satish here. I'm playing a general evaluator today. My roles and responsibility is my role evaluator whole meeting. My responsibility is only for make you all understand where we are making a mistakes, not to find out the mistakes. With that, I have a two set of team. Number one is TAC team. TAC stands for T is timer, A for accounter, and G for grammarian. This is a time for introduce my first team, TAC team. Today is a timer, Toastmaster Lakshmi Narayanan sir. Toastmaster Lakshmi Narayanan, he is a very senior Toastmaster in, I think he's in a Coimbatore club. Now he's recently back to our Chennai Toastmaster club. Toastmaster Lakshmi Narayanan, please read out your project objective, please.
Thank you, TM Satish. This is Lakshmi Narayana. I'm from CTM, as always, and I'm in Chennai only. Okay, as a timer, I'll observe and record the time, the formal speeches, the table topics, and the evaluations take time. Because to have an efficient meeting, we must control both the duration of the speaker's time and also session time. I will also alert each speaker of the time they have left by using the green, yellow, and red card. For example, if there is a prepared speech for 5 to 7 minutes duration, by the end of 5 minutes, I'll show green card. By end of 6 minutes, I'll show an yellow card. And by the end of 7 minutes, I'll show a red card. And after that, you will have a grace period of 30 seconds. But at the end of this meeting, when the general evaluator calls upon, I'll give you the report. Over to general evaluator. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for your detailed report. And second for accounter. Accounter today is Toastmaster Velu Nilakandan. He is a very special person in our Toastmaster. Because when we started with our Toastmaster journey before 2 years, he was the president of our club. We all inspired by his leadership. And now also, he was inspiring for each and every meeting. Still now, he is an unofficial mentor to me. He is a Toastmaster, official mentor in my personal life. This is the time to introduce Toastmaster Venu Nilakandan. Please read out your project objective.
Good evening, Ananda. And thank you, General Evaluator Sadish. I am Venu Nilakandan. Today, I am playing the role of accountant. Today, my duty is to note down all the R's, M's, and S fillers and crutch words and repeated words, unnecessary pauses by the speakers and role players. I will submit my report at the end of the meeting when I will be called upon by the general evaluator. Thank you, general evaluator.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for your detailed submission of your report. And second for third for Toastmaster Srikanth Puttikrishnan, today is playing as a grammarian. He's in our a club for a motivational speaker, whenever we feel it is sad, whenever we make a mistake, we will go to him and he will guide him for a good suggestion and good improvement, how we can go for a better in next version of our life. Toastmaster Srikant Puttikrishnan, please read out your project objective.
Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you, General Evaluator. As our Toastmaster of the day was referring to a book written by Robin Sharma, I would like to share a book that which I read very recently. A couple of times I've read it. It's titled Man's Search for Meaning. Man's Search for Meaning by Viktor E. Frankl. It's a 1946 book, and this is about the author sharing his near-death experience during the World War II in a Nazi concentration camp. I read a few pages of the book. It gave me a chill. I didn't have to read any further. So gripping, and the mind that he had to overcome these experiences and come out successfully is the theme of this book. Exciting book at any cost, but also a little bit frightening. I recommend all of you to read it to know how strong the willpower of a man can be. Being the grammarian this afternoon for the meeting, I would be listening to each and every speaker. I would be noting down the good usage of English language, and I would also be recommending where there could be improvement in certain places where the speakers would have made a mistake. Word of the day today is opportunity. I repeat, opportunity. And an example of using the word opportunity is when the opportunity came for him to prove that he could be and do the job. I repeat, when the opportunity came for him to prove that he could do the job. One more example is, I had the rare opportunity of speaking to the president. I would be submitting my report as and when called upon by the general evaluator. Thank you very much. Enjoy your meeting. Back to Toastmaster Satish.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for your detailed submission. And now we'll go for the next set of team, my evaluation team. I don't want to introduce them right now because they're going to evaluate for all the prepared speeches. Later part of the meeting, once TT session is over, I will introduce for my second set of team. Now, hand over again to Toastmaster Geeta ma'am.
Thank you, Toastmaster Satish Babu. Now that we have learned the word of the day is opportunity, how about learning about an idiom for the day? So to give us the idiom of the day, we have Toastmaster Aishwarya, who is the VPPR of our club. Not only that, she's also an enthusiastic Toastmaster, and she takes up roles not only in the club level, but also during the contests and intra-club activities also. So with these words, I hand over the proceedings to Toastmaster Aishwarya.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Geeta. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and esteemed guests. So I'll be playing the role of the idiom master. And I'd like to share a small story. It was the year 2019, where I was pursuing my final year in my college. And that time, the college was snowed under with the inter-college culturals. And this memory is like a blast from the past as well. Until one day, a faculty came to me and she asked me whether I could host the offstage events, which consist of 5 to 6 events. And I grabbed the opportunity as keen as a mustard. I was super excited as it was the first time for me to host a cultural. And I was waiting for a co-host so that things can be even more simpler and easier until and unless we break the task into two. The day arrived, the cultural's day arrived. The co-host and I, we did our job very well. We blew everyone's socks off and we dotted our I's and crossed our T's. At the end of the day, the day came to an end. And I was so proud of myself and my co-host as well that we have done, we have almost managed 6 to 7 events in a day, without any break or something. So we were proud of ourselves. And before I could go to my home, the same faculty came back to me and she told me that she was very happy with what I have done, what we have done, and the entire team was elated with the performance. And now I would like to share the following idioms which I have used. I hope you can see the screen. So the following idioms which were used was a blast from the past, which means something that suddenly makes you remember an earlier time in your life. Snowed under, which means being busy with or engaged with some kind of work. And I have mentioned as keen as a mustard, which means being excited and enthusiastic. I've also mentioned dotted I's and crossed T's, meaning is pay a great deal of attention to the details when you're doing a task. And another few idioms were blow someone's socks off, meaning amaze or impress someone. Be home and host to successfully completed a task or an activity. Take the floor. At that time, like, since it was the first time for me, I took the floor and I also found my feet at that moment. So that means to take the floor means to stand up and address gathering, and find your feet means to become familiar with and confident in your situation. And the main highlight which the faculty came to me and asked was the cream of the crop, which means the best of all. And with this, I pretty much covered all the idioms, and I hand over the control back to our TMO.
Thank you, Toastmaster Aishwarya. That was really wonderful to learn so many idioms, that too in the form of a story, and that too a personal story. It requires a lot of creativity and effort. Thank you so much. We now move on to how about learning a quote today? So let me invite our experienced Toastmaster, Toastmaster Thyagarajan, to share the quote for the day. Over to you, Toastmaster Thyagarajan. Sir, you're on mute. You're on mute, Toastmaster.
Yes, I am muted.
Yes, we can hear you now.
Unmuted. Yes. Salutations to all of you. This is Toastmaster T.R. Thyagarajan addressing you. First, let me take the privilege of, thanking Mr. VP Education for having given me an opportunity to be a maiden role as Toastmaster. Quote of the day is, lesser you talk, better you will listen. Yes, that is, I coined this quote. Okay, lesser, I repeat it, lesser you talk, better you will listen. Yes, see, way back in 1863, the great American president, yes, Abraham Lincoln, known for his abolition of his slavery, delivered an historical speech, yes, known as Gettysburg Speech, in which he concludes the speech with a very famous observation, which is even now quoted by eminent parliamentarians. Democracy is by the people, for the people, of the people. Yes, and this speech will remain and remembered by the posterity as far as the English language survives. And, you know, how many words this speech consists of? 353 words that you should remember. Yes, not even the words that you are allowed to use in an icebreaker. 353 words. And the same platform, another celebrity spoke. His speech consisted of 1,063 words. His name was Edward Everett. He was holding the office of Secretary of State. And these 1,063 words, who remembers the speech now? Blah, 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 blah. I have read both the speeches in the Connemara Library. Abraham Lincoln's speech and Edward Everett's speech. Abraham Lincoln's message was very potential. Yes, equality, fraternity, and liberty. Yes. Yes, the slogan of the French Revolution. Okay. Now, oh, Toastmaster, whenever you prepare a speech, edit it. What is editing? It's an art for which I cannot explain it in half a minute. Yes. So, one tip I can give you, reread it again and again. You will see the excessive fat. Excessive fat refers to verbosity, unnecessary words. You can track it, the verbosity or excessive words. Then you deliver your speech. Then your speech will be listened to by all. Thank you all. Again, repeat the quote, lesser you talk, better you will listen. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Toastmaster Thyagarajan. Now we move on to yet another learning from the book, The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari. The second principle that we learn here in this book is to live a life of purpose. Now, how is this going to be possible? So this is going to be possible only when we have specified goals and objectives. So these can be in the personal level, in the professional level, and it can be also spiritual goals. Once we set up our goals clearly, they play the role of the lighthouse, similar to that lighthouse that directs the ship when the ships are in distress, when the sea is rough. So once we live a life of purpose, then we are sure to attain a lot of happiness and success in our life. Now we'll move on to our next session, which is the prepared speech section. So in this section, we have a set of prepared speakers who have a definite goal and aim that they want to take their speech to the next level. Let us hear from them. Our first speaker today is Toastmaster Ratika Jain. She's giving her icebreakers today. And to tell you something about Toastmaster Ratika, she's recently graduated and she's she's also working as an intern. She had rocked our meeting last week as the Toastmaster of the day. So before inviting Toastmaster Ratika, I would like to invite her evaluator, Toastmaster Rekha, to read out the speech objectives. Over to you, Toastmaster Rekha.
Thank you, Toastmaster. Thank you, Toastmaster Geeta. So the purpose, the project objective of Toastmaster Ratika is, the purpose of this project is for Vratika to introduce herself to the club and learn the basic structure of public speaking. So Vratika's project, or it's an icebreaker. So her title is Who Am I? All the very best, Toastmaster Vratika. Back to you, Toastmaster Geeta.
Who am I? Toastmaster Vratika? Who am I?
Good evening, everyone. I'm Ratika Jain, and I am a 2020 graduate from BITS Pilani campus. I did my bachelor's in electronics and instrumentation discipline. I currently work at Mentor Graphics. It is a child company of Siemens and is based in Noida. My father, Mr. Roop Singh Chaudhary, is a vice president in one of the cement companies in Chennai. My mom, Mrs. Neelam Chaudhary, is a homemaker and has recently started dealership of Modi Care products. My younger brother, Parth Jain, is pursuing Bachelor of Technology in Computer Science from IIT Bombay. This was my short intro. Not that interesting, right? Let us dive deep to know who I actually am, to know my family background, and to know some of my sweet and bitter memories from the past. Let me take you back to 13th December, 1997. I was born in chilly winters of Barmer, Rajasthan. Barmer literally means a place which often faces flood-like situations. Ironically, it is one of the driest places in Rajasthan and hence one of the coldest. Having said that, since I was the first girl to be born in my both maternal and paternal family, I was welcomed with lots of love and affection. My childhood was spent just like any other kid, playing, studying, breaking stuff, crying, annoying my parents, etc., etc. As I grew up, I noticed one thing, that I was older than most of my classmates. When I asked my parents that, why did you not put me into school on time? You won't believe what they said. They said that it slipped out of their minds. What? Who in the world forgets to put their child into school? And they have been scolding me for putting my wet towel on the bed. Do you see the irony? Anyways, my father has been in the private sector from the very beginning. With the joy of promotions and salary raises came the tedious task of relocation and house hunting. You won't believe, but I have changed my school 5 times, and this count is even greater for my younger brother, which is 7. We won't be surprised if you would call us nomads of the 21st century. We would get it. This reminds me of an incident from my school life. I don't remember which school that was, by the way. But I remember that I had to fill a form, and in that form, I had to fill my permanent address. I was like, permanent address. What's that? I didn't know what my permanent address was. I had to call my father and ask him. Coming to my education, after class 10th, I moved to the education city of India, that is Kota, to prepare for JEE. And after 2 years of hard work and a lot of crying, I managed to achieve All India rank 427 in JEE mains. But since most of my friends from Kota were going to BITS Pilani, and I was so petrified even at the thought of making new friends, that even I enrolled in BITS Pilani. Petrified, you might ask? Yes. Even after changing 5 schools and moving to a new place every now and then, I was really, really bad at talking to new people and making new friends. I don't think confidence was the issue, because when it came to dancing and singing, I would willingly go up on the stage without even a sign of nervousness. I recently found out that this fear of public speaking is called glossophobia. And I remember that this fear of mine was a huge barrier to communicate during my placements as well. As Toastmaster Thyagarajan just said, that lesser you talk, more you listen. But for me, it was like, I wouldn't talk at all. So my mom had been pestering me for joining Toastmasters since my 3rd year of college. And I had been ignoring her successfully until a few months back. One day I got so irritated that I decided, okay, I am going to join Toastmasters. And I did. And I joined one of the best Toastmasters clubs. Had it been regular offline meetings, it would have been very difficult for me to join a club full of new people. I would like to thank this pandemic too for easing my way into this club. On a serious note, I heard yesterday that Toastmaster Puneet said that an investment made in yourself is the best investment ever. And I couldn't agree more. Joining Toastmasters has been the best decision of my life. And from the bottom of my heart, I can feel that I feel confident already. Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity to speak in front of you all. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you, Toastmaster Vratika, for the wonderful icebreakers. We now move on to our next speaker. Our next speaker is Toastmaster Deepak Thompson. Toastmaster Deepak Thompson is giving his presentation mastery project level 1 evaluation and feedback. So before I call upon Toastmaster Deepak Thompson, I will request his evaluator Toastmaster Guru to read out the speech objectives. Over to you, Toastmaster Guru.
Toastmaster Gita, it was Shiva. Evaluating.
Toastmaster Shiva will be evaluating Toastmaster Deepak's speech.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah. Thanks for the confirmation. Yeah, hi, good evening all. Thanks for giving me this opportunity. Yeah, the purpose of the today's speech for Deepak was, he was attempting his L1 P2 to present a speech on any topic, receive feedback and apply the feedback to the second speech. The purpose of this speech is for the member to present a speech and receive feedback from the evaluator. Deepak, break a leg. Over to Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you, Toastmaster Shiva. Toastmaster Deepak Thompson, the choices we make. The choices we make, Toastmaster Deepak Thompson.
Hello, am I audible and visible? Toastmaster Geeta, am I audible and visible?
Yes, you're audible and visible.
Okay, thank you. So life is a matter of choices. The choices you make makes you, says John Maxwell. So I'm here to talk about the choices we make. So I was thinking, what topic should I have to choose? Well, as usual, I browse through the internet and I see numerous choices available, but I am unable to choose any one of it. Then I decided I'm going to choose what choice I have to make. That is the topic, choices we make. So now, several years back, I'm going around the memory lane. Several years back, my mom asked my dad to go and buy vegetables in a market. My dad called me and took me to the market along with him. So when I went to the market, I saw my dad and asked him. I just looked at him at first and I asked him, "Dad, do you know how to cook?" Then my dad told, "No, I don't know, son." Then I asked, "Do you know what mom is going to cook?" Then my dad told, "No, I don't know. Why are you asking these questions?" Then I told, "You didn't ask the question which is most required at this time. What vegetable should I have to buy to my mom?" Then my dad told, "Look around you, son. What do you see?" I saw around. I saw a lot of vegetables, lot of people standing. It was so lively around there. It was so good, refreshing. It was too good to see that. Then I told, "There is a lot of vegetables, lot of choices we have." Then I told my dad, "Dad, how do you know what I am going to choose from here?" Then my dad told, "This is the life, son. The life is filled with lot of choices around you. You just need to see it and see the good in it, and you have to choose it. You have to choose what you like. I have to choose what your mom likes. I also have to choose what you like and what is good for your health. And I will buy those, and your mom will choose what she has to cook for the day." The entire world is filled with bounty of surprises, bounty of choices for us to choose. So we in the world right now are so narrow-minded, looking straight. We have to break the barrier. We have to see beyond. We are having so many opportunities, but still we feel we have to see in a straight line. So my guests and Toastmasters, please see beyond and see all the opportunities you are missing out. One day my dad asked me, "Where are you going to study? What is your goal?" Then I told, "I am going to become a pilot." Then after some time, I changed my mind, seeing some doctors earning more. Then I told, "I'm going to become a doctor." Then I read the biology book, which my sister was studying earlier. I opened the biology book. I started reading the word chrysanthemum. Then I couldn't understand, what is the chrysanthemum? It is called chrysanthemum. So it is so hard to read out even a single word in a biology. Then I decided I'm not going to be a doctor. then I'm going to be an engineer. Now I'm going to compare myself with fellow engineers, my brother. I compared one of my cousin brother, whether he is a very good engineer and he is placed in US, he is getting a very good salary. So I'm going to become a mechanical engineer. So I told my dad, hey dad, I'm going to become a mechanical engineer. Then my dad told, okay son, we will put you in a college, you will become a mechanical engineer. So now my friend came to me and asked, Macha, what did you choose? Then I told, I chose mechanical engineer. Then he told, man, you made a wrong choice. Why? He told, there are no girls in the class. Then I have to live with the consequences of it. So now I am okay. I did play around. I did enjoy my college days very well. I was a basketball player. I was a football player and a volleyball player. I learned everything. It was so good. Now, many of us even struggle with how to choose with the choices we have. We may go to a shop. We may struggle to choose what dress should I buy. There are a lot of choices available. So, and we may go to get a gift. We will struggle with choices. How many of you struggle with choices? I know for a fact, everyone used to struggle with choices at some point after in their life. I am introducing you to a new tool which will help you to make choice-based decision when you struggle. So I quickly share a content here. So let me know how many categories. There are two major categories when you choose. You have to choice. You have a choice for yourself. You have to make choice for yourself, and then you have to make choice for others. Then now, in these two categories, I am introducing you VBOT. This is the tool. So V as a value. How much value you are going to decide? You are going to, the decision you are making, is it value to you, or how much value does it make to others? And then you are going to decide based on budget. Budget, is it what is the maximum I can spend? Can I afford it? What will it affect my other long-term plans? Check on that. And then others, impact on others. The decision I make, will it impact others? Will it good way or in a bad way? If it's a bad way, will you live with the consequences? So think about it. And then last, the time. Is it the right time or can it be postponed? So I'm introducing you again, VBOT. So choose wisely. There are multiple choices. You have to choose wisely. You are free to choose, but you are bound with the consequences. Thank you. Back to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you, Master Deepak Thompson. That was a beautiful message. You are a product of the choices that you make. That was really wonderful placed. We move on to our next speaker. Our next speaker is Distinguished Toastmaster Ram Nelluru. His speech title is Kidnapped. DTM Ram Nelluru is giving his level 3. The project is storytelling. To tell you all a few words about him, DTM Ram Nelluru is a business analyst and he loves reading books, and currently he's missing his long drives. So before I call upon to DTM Ram Nelluru, I request his evaluator, DTM Nina John, to please kindly read out the speech objectives.
Thank you, Toastmaster today, Madam Geeta Shroff. DTM Ram Nelluru is going to present his level 3 project, Storytelling. This has to do with how do you present a story and how does it impact the audience. So, welcome to DTM Ram Nelluru, topic Kidnapped. Back to the speaker.
Thank you. This is a real story of a kidnap happened in USA. The kidnapped girl was a 4 years daughter of my friend. It was night, 10 o'clock. I was enjoying my long drive while sipping my favorite cup of coffee. I was driving a 14-seater passenger vehicle, which was rented by me and my friends to visit Niagara Falls. My eyes were seeing the road, my ears were listening to the music, but my mind was not paying attention because it stuck at the most spectacular, beautiful, and incredible view of Niagara Falls. No matter how distracted you are, you will be alert when a police car is coming behind you and asking you to stop at a dark and deserted highway. By the time I find a spot to stop the van, I could see one more police car. No, wait, two more police cars. I was not even over speeding. Why I have the honor of being escorted by three police cars? I started worrying. I stopped the van and kept my hands on the steering wheel and asked my friend not to do any unnecessary moves and asked him to keep the hands where the police can see. Because US police are known to shoot people when they were startled. And they will be very uncomfortable if they can't see your hands. I could see in the rearview mirror, a lean, tall, and young police officer was approaching the van with his hand on his gun. He was walking very carefully. And his fellow officer was standing behind a police car door, very alert. When you are in uncertainty, your mind will start playing all the tricks. It was the time when Trump government was arresting Mexican immigrants and separating their children from the parents. We heard the stories of Indians being threatened to leave the country. We remembered the stories of police stopping some people and shooting at highways if they are suspects. We were worried. The officer came to our window and I greeted him with a smile. "Good evening, officer. How can I help you?" He started his questioning. "What's your name? Where are you coming from? Where are you going? Where did you stay in your trip? Where did you stop your vehicle on the way?" He took my driving license and went back to his vehicle. 15 to 20 minutes later, he came back. "Which country are you from? Who is your employer? Why are you here?" This time, he took our passports and went back. Like this, every 15, 20 minutes, a police officer will come and ask some questions, really nonsense questions sometimes. Suddenly he asked, one person asked, "Do you have guns?" "What? I don't even fire Diwali crackers." Another person came and asked, "Do you have drugs?" "I have not even tasted beer in my life." And one person came and asked, as if I am kidnapping children, he asked, "Who are these children?" And he looked at the children and asked, "Who are these people? Are they really your parents?" We were really worried. My friends were really in dismay. I tried to keep them calm and try my usual humor, but nothing was working because it was very uncomfortable. We were not supposed to start the car. We are not supposed to get down on a highway. All the insects and mosquitoes are zooming inside the vehicle. After 3 hours of this, long 3 hours of this, an officer came and told, "My friend's immigration documents are having issues." So he asked him to slowly step down and get into police car to talk to the immigration officers. Fortunately, he brought his laptop to the trip. He was able to show additional documentation he required. So he went to police car and his wife started crying. Children started complaining. It was absolute chaos for next 1 hour. We don't know what they are doing with my friend. We were really surprised with this entire drama. After 1 hour, they brought him back to the car and told, "You guys are lucky. You have the laptop and you are able to answer questions. Otherwise, it would have been a nightmare for you. Now you can leave." What? Leave? Why did you stop us in the first place? You have been refusing to answer that question. Then he revealed the shocking answer. Before they stop us, half an hour before they stop us, we stopped at a petrol pump, which they call gas station, to use restrooms and get coffee. While we went inside the store, all the children were sleeping in the car and my wife was taking care of them. Suddenly, my friend's 4-year-old daughter woke up from the sleep and started crying, telling that she needed to go to restroom very urgently. So my wife took her and ran to the restrooms and gave it to her mother and came back to the car. One concerned gentleman saw this and complained to the emergency contact, saying we were kidnapping children. And police took 4 hours to verify our records and watch the CCTV cameras. And they said, "You can leave." I looked at the officer and laughed and said, "Officer, we did not kidnap children. You kidnapped us for 4 hours. He laughed and said, "Sorry, man, we were doing our business." Imagine my friend's reaction when I looked at them as they're still trying to recover. "Guys, I know what to speak in my next Toastmaster meeting." I can guarantee you the person who complained and went home with the satisfaction of saving children from the kidnappers, he would have definitely shared his story in Facebook and got some likes and reactions also. We suffered 4 hours for nothing. No, not for nothing. I learned 3 things from this. First, you have to be calm whenever there is some difficult situation. Try hard to be calm. And second, carry all the necessary and unnecessary documents with you when you are outside India. And third, most important, never ever run with a crying child in your hand. Over to the Toastmaster.
Thank you, Toastmaster DTM Ram Nelluru, for the wonderful speech. That was really dramatic and scary indeed. Glad that you're all safe and it was settled off very fast. Yes, we now move on to the next section. But before that, let me share yet another understanding that I have from this book. So this book tells us that we need to respect our time. So only when we are able to respect our time and set up priorities and use our time wisely, we will be able to achieve success in our lives. This is also supported with a quote which says that time slips through our hands like little grains of sand, never to return back. So let us use our time wisely and let us have a balanced approach to succeed in life. Moving on to the next section, it is table topic session. So I urge you all, I tell you all that this is the right time to make use of this opportunity. Volunteer yourselves, especially the non-role players and even the guests. Just volunteer yourselves, participate enthusiastically, and I'm sure you're going to gain a lot of confidence when it comes to participating in table topic session. And to handle this session, today we have with us Toastmaster Kritika. To tell you all a few words about Toastmaster Kritika, she's a HR in Ernst & Young. And I would also like to tell you all that recently our club has started up with the Toastmaster of the Month title. So if they were to start the Table Topic Speaker of the Month, then I'm sure it's going to be grabbed by Toastmaster Kritika. That's how good she is when it comes to participating in table topics. And today she's a table topic master, and I'm sure you're going to all have an interesting session with her. Over to you, Toastmaster Kritika.
Thank you, Toastmaster Geeta, for that wonderful introduction. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. It gives me immense pleasure in taking up this role today And let me tell you what Table Topics is and why this session is so important. Table Topics is an impromptu speaking session that helps you to gain knowledge into speaking and thinking very quickly and using your words to frame sentences as quickly as possible. So with this, let me tell you one more thing. The time allotted for a Table Topic speaker is 1 to 2 minutes. So you will have a minimum of 1 minute and a maximum of 2 minutes. You will be given a grace period of 30 seconds to complete your speech. Let's begin with the TD session. Do we have Toastmaster Abhilash? Okay. Let me call upon Toastmaster Shrikant.
Yes, I am here.
Yes, Toastmaster Shrikant. Your topic would be,
yes?
Why is red the new white? Why is red the new white? Toastmaster Shrikant.
Thank you, Table Topic Master. Red is the new white is for the simple reason we have learned a very important lesson during this pandemic. This coronavirus is playing hide and seek with all of us. None of the scientific and medical community is able to come to terms how to treat and cure it. But there is one particular treatment which says gives a ray of hope for COVID patients, and that is plasma treatment. And this plasma is from your blood, which is red. And when you take this red and give it to a COVID patient, the recovery rate as per CDC, Center for Disease Control of United States, it says it is more than 90%. So a red blood which gives the plasma makes the patient suffering from COVID get back his life, and he becomes wild. He becomes full of energy. He comes back. He's so happy that he's got his life back. And that signals white. White also signals peace, harmony, and happiness. So red today is the new white. People are looking for recovered patients of COVID to donate their plasma. And this plasma has given us a ray of hope for recovery until a vaccine is found to treat COVID patients. Red is definitely a white in this situation. Thank you very much. Back to you.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Toastmaster Shrikant. The next one will go to Toastmaster Satish Babu. Toastmaster Satish.
Yes, yes, KT Master.
Your topic is silence is golden, but not in Toastmasters. Silence is golden, but not in Toastmasters. Toastmaster Satish.
Thank you so much for the wonderful topic. And before I start the speech, I must tell you to all Toastmaster now. When TT Master Kritika called for the Shrikant requested for a speech, I replied her, please don't call for a role player. And next message she sent that next speaker for you. So thank you so much for the opportunity, Toastmaster Kritika. To answer your topic, silent is a golden and not from the TT Master, right? What is the topic?
Silence is golden, but not in Toastmasters.
Okay. Silent is golden, not in Toastmasters. See, and as a Toastmaster, for everyone to improve their communication and the leadership quality. So silent make a sense in all the way, but if you want to be in a public speaker, only way is you should not be in a silent. So that's my point for your requesting. Thank you so much, and hand over to you again, Toastmaster Kritika.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Toastmaster Satish. Can we have any nominations? Can we have somebody who would like to nominate themselves? Yes, Toastmaster Hari. Tell me. Mr. Hari Shankar?
Hi.
Yes, sir. How are you? Long time, sir.
Yeah, doing okay.
Okay. So your topic is the three most important women in your life. The three most important women in your life, Mr. Hari Shankar.
So the three most important women. So if I have to divide this, thanks for the topic, Kritika, and good afternoon, everyone. So the three most important women. So different phases of life, you have different people important, right? During the childhood, when I was in school, the three most important women were my mother, the school teacher, and the servant maid who was taking care of me. And so these were the three important women. But if you look at college, mine was a co-ed, so there were multiple people. So I was looking at seniors as well. So there were more than three people. And yes, now that actually I'm pretty old now, and the three most important women are mostly, I don't know whether my wife is watching, so I have to say it's my wife. So most important. So even I have to report to her everyday status, when I'm coming, when I'm going. So she takes care of the family. So when I do all the traveling, so I can say that, yes, different phases of life. You have different women always taking care of you. And behind every successful man, there is a woman. I'm happy to say that, yes, always, all through my life, I had been ably supported by women, which has enabled to be a successful human being today. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Ms. Hari Shankar. Our next speaker would be Toastmaster Puneet. Toastmaster Puneet, are you there?
Table topic master.
Yes, you are audible. Yes, you're audible and visible.
Okay, yeah.
Your Thank topic you. Is start your speech with long, long ago, so long ago, I lived in a creepy mansion. Start your speech with long, long ago, so long ago, I lived in a creepy mansion. Toastmaster Puneet.
Long, long ago, not so long ago, I don't know how long ago, I lived in a creepy mansion. And yes, it is in Chennai, when I was in there in the lockdown, helpless, desolate, I don't know what I was gonna do. And yes, although I was living in it was like a 3 BHK in Mahindra World City, a beautiful villa. But let me be honest, when the Wi-Fi goes off, believe me, that's the most haunting. It's similar to being in an ancient olden times. Thank you, Madam Table Topic Master Kritika, for this beautiful topic. Yes, this experience I had some seven months back, thanks to pandemic, of course, wherein all the transportations were literally cut off, chopped off. And so I was helpless. And even more helpless was my roommate did not pay the internet bill on time. So we were running short of internet. So I was not able to enjoy some Toastmasters meeting also. So all that happiness, which we all look forward to Sunday, was gone for some time. But having said that, better late than never, my friend did renew it. And to be honest, when every adversity brings an opportunity. So to be honest, I never used to wash utensils. I'm a bit arrogant, a bit, what you can call it. My parents have pampered me so much that I'm literally like the king of the house. But then this pandemic has taught me to be much more responsible, thanks to my roommate. So we would always divide tasks, since maids were not allowed to come since due to it was intense lockdown. So I, my roommate Mohit, we would take turns to clean up the house. I would normally clean up the utensils. I would do chopping of vegetables. And I think this kind of situation has made me much more responsible. And now when I come home, if I don't wash my utensil, I feel a bit awkward, because that kind of new habit has been created thanks to this situation. And kudos, and thanks to being in that haunted cave, wherein I was able to learn a bit of domestic course. So I think that's it. Being in 3 BHK villa, which is Aqualily in Mahindra World City, is indeed a scary experience. It was indeed like living in a cave, but then there was an opportunity for all of us to learn and grow. And I thank for that pandemic. technique that I was able to learn I'm basics of daily course. So my future spouse will be happy that I can do some domestic work. Number two, table topic master critical.
Tell me beforehand via message. My order is on.
I think I'm done. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Toastmaster Puneet. Thank you. Okay. Is there any guest who'd like to volunteer? Any guest who'd like to volunteer? Mr. Manoj? Mr. Manoj, your audio is in mute. Yeah.
No, am I audible?
Yes, sir. You're audible. Yeah. Your topic would be, has quarantine become the new normal? Has quarantine become the new normal, Mr. Manoj?
When you are locked up in a room, when there is no possibility to communicate with anyone, you will find new ways. The new ways to communicate, the new means and new mode that will diametrically change our lives. Thank you so much for the Table Topic Master for the splendid opportunity that you had given to me. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters. Sometime we all feel that we are stuck at something. And that is, in fact, later on turn out to be a great opportunity of stretching ourselves from our comfort levels. You could see now, there were many days I have seen my little daughter and the little boy, my little son, both of them were not able to go to school and they were sitting in the home and playing. And they were finding it very difficult. They cannot go to the playground. They cannot go outside. But then the multiple array of the online courses appeared. There were many things even which will diametrically change their lives itself. The coding and various topics, the teachers were there on the line. And they could get sufficient time to read so much of books. And now I could also see that the people here on the streets, they find it so, sanitation has become very much important in their lives. Sometime, you know, there is something which is very hard hammering on the people that would finally turn them or alchemy, becoming a changing agent like an alchemy, that they become more conscious of sanity, health, etc. And certainly, Madam Table Topic Master, that the quarantine has turned out to be a new life, a new dimension in our lives, which has opened up a lot of avenues in the online marketing and the online motivation speeches and the online way of doing the business. Over to you, Table Topic Master. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Mr. Manoj. That was an amazing thing. Is Abhilash available? Abhilash?
Yeah.
Toastmaster Abhilash.
Yes, here.
Yeah. Your topic is, if an alien lands in a Toastmasters meeting, okay? If an alien lands in a Toastmasters meeting, as the VP membership of the club, how will you convince him or her to become a member? You want me to repeat the question?
Just once more, please.
Yeah. If an alien lands in a Toastmasters meeting as the VPM, how will you convince him or her to join the meeting and to become part of Toastmasters?
Good evening, my dear fellow Toastmasters. Yes. Thank you, Toastmaster Kirtika, for this wonderful topic. At the outset, I would like to focus on one thing. So before I took over the mantle of the VP membership for this term, the VP membership for the last term was a certain person by name Toastmaster Kritika, who is the TT master now. And she taught me much of what is to be told to that alien. All right. So with that said, an alien comes, see, a Toastmaster club, you know, as the Sergeant at Arms begins during the meeting, a Toastmasters club is there to develop communication and your leadership skills. And see, an alien is coming here and he
In order for him to gain more acceptability and everything amongst us, I believe communication and leadership is even more essential for him than for us normal human beings. So I will tell him that, come on in, take a Toastmaster club, come on in, join into a Toastmaster club, finish a couple of paths, and you're good to go into this world as a normal human being. That said and done, the second pitch that I will have for him is, we have so many distinguished Toastmasters in our club, and the next point I will do is to introduce him to Nina ma'am and Zach sir for a brief on Toastmasters. So I believe that is more than sufficient to convince him to join our Toastmaster club. If else, the final pitch is going to be to Toastmaster Kritika. I believe that is the final icing on the cake. Over to you, Table Topics Master.
Thank you, Toastmaster Abhilash. I think you're punishing me for calling you anyway. Next, let's have Toastmaster Nagendra Bharti. Sir?
Yes,
Toastmaster. Yes, sir. Your topic would be, if the phrase, my life, my rules, apply to you, what are three rules you will make for yourself and abide by them? If the phrase, my life, my rules, were to apply to you, what are the three rules you'll make for yourself in life? Toastmaster Nagendra Bhatt.
Thank you, Toastmaster Kritika. My life, my rules, three rules.
Yes, sir.
The first rule would be, I would like to win the A division contest, which is going to happen in November 8th. That is the first rule I am going to make for my life. Because I already succeeded in area contest.
Okay.
Now next level is division contest. So I will make it as a rule for my life and I will work hard to achieve that. The second thing is, I want to be always young at my heart. Even though I have many medical problems in my body. So I would like to be always 30 in my life, even though I have crossed 60. To achieve that goal, what should I do? Maybe doing exercise or meditation. So this also I will make it as a rule. That is the second rule. Third rule, whenever I attend Toastmasters meeting, I don't want the TT speaker to call me to make a speech, to expose my ignorance. So that would be the third rule. So with these three rules, I think I can manage my BP, I can manage my cholesterol, and I can manage my sugar, and I can live healthily, happily. As I said, with the mental age of 30, even beyond 100, along with that, I would also expect my wife also to live with me till the time so that we can happily live together as we are today. From the day when we got married, that is at the age of 18 years. Yes, we got married at the age of 18 years. Don't say it is a child marriage. That happened because of the family problems. My parents and her parents, they were staunch enemies. So our grandparents made that arrangement. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you. Can we have Toastmaster Aishwarya? Toastmaster Aishwarya?
Here.
Yes. Your topic is, what do you think is the greatest invention of mankind? What do you think is the greatest invention of mankind? Toastmaster Aishwarya.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Kritika, for the topic. So the greatest invention of mankind would be the way of kindness. Because the more you help the other people, you'll be more satisfied actually. So now recently I have been scrolling through the Instagram feed and I came across a Blue Cross post of an abundant country dog being rescued. And I found many other posts similar to the same. And I felt so sad that like it has been affected due to something else, like let's say it has some eye infection or something like that. And people are there readily, you know, volunteering those dogs or cats or even any other animal, and then bringing them back, bringing them to the Blue Cross, you know, that office, the rescue service office, and then the officials or the staff over there giving them treatments and giving them food on time. So that small act of kindness brings a smile on almost everyone's face, and it also brought a smile on my face, and I also had to, you know, question myself, why am I not doing that? So me being as an animal lover, like I literally had to, you know, question myself. So that small act of kindness is the greatest, like the greatest gift to mankind. So with this, I hand over the control. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Toastmaster Aishwarya. Kindness is indeed the greatest gift to mankind. Is there anybody who is willing to volunteer themselves for a TT topic? Is there anybody? You can unmute yourself.
Yeah, Deepak here.
Deepak. Yes, sir? Yes, sir, yeah. Your topic, sir, is a book that inspired you very much. A book that inspired you very much, and why would you recommend other people read it? A book that inspired you very much, and why would you recommend other people to read it? Toastmaster Deepak.
Thank you, Toastmaster and Table Topic Master Kritika. Actually, the topic I was expecting, it is nowhere near to the book, because I don't like studying at all. Whenever I take a book, I take it so that I can sleep quickly. So even in my college days, even in my school, if I'm having trouble to sleep, I will open up a book so that I will fall in sleep immediately. So the topic is somewhere irrelevant for me, but however, I did like think, where there are lots of images, stories, everything has a moral attached to the stories. So those morals kept me going, and it was really good reading those books. Even as an elderly person, you can go through the book and read it. Thank you very much, Toastmaster Kritika, for the opportunity.
Thank you very much. Thank you. With this, I hand over control to the Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Geeta. Thank you,
Toastmaster Kritika. The topics were really interesting. And we had lovely speakers giving out their views, very sarcastic views, very, very nice it was. The session was really very interesting. Thank you so much. Now, coming on to the next principle. The next principle that this book talks about is the principle of Kaizen. Follow the principle of Kaizen. So what is this Kaizen? Anybody?
It's a small Japanese changes. Term that is used for quality, right? Quality management.
Yeah. It's small changes.
Yeah.
Small improvements.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So this is a Japanese concept which emphasizes on continuous learning and improvement. So this basically comes from doing the things that we fear to do, which means once we decide or dream about something, we should have the courage to do those things, to fight our fears. And once we uplift ourselves, then the universe will have our back and our lives will be very interesting, happy, and we will be successful in our lives. So this is something exactly what the Toastmasters also emphasizes on. That is the continuous improvement and continuous learning. So that's how this we have this evaluation session as of now. So this is a session where our prepared speakers, they are given an opportunity to, you know, get instant feedback from the fellow Toastmasters, the experienced Toastmasters, so that they can take their speeches to the next level. They also have the tag team that helps them with how, if they were able to express their thoughts in the prescribed time and if the speech was free of interruptions. So when they go through this evaluation project, I'm sure it will definitely help them to bring out their speeches in a really better way. So with this, I hand over the control to the general evaluator of today's meeting to conduct this evaluation session that emphasizes on continuous learning and improvement. Over to you, Toastmaster Satish Babu.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Geeta. Good evening once again, dear Toastmaster. This is a time for introduce me as a, my second team. This is for evaluation team. Now, we all heard that proposed speech session, three speakers. Now, we will going to evaluate all the speakers along with my evaluators. Today, Toastmaster Rekha going to evaluate Toastmaster Vartika's speech. Toastmaster Rekha, please share your evaluation report.
Yeah, sure, General Evaluator. Toastmaster Vrithika's objective, first of all, congratulations Toastmaster Vrithika for taking your first step into the prepared speech. And the objective of her speech is to introduce yourself. And she did the job very well because I was not aware of her, though we have been there in the meetings. Like from this speech, I was able to understand or know about her. So I would say the basic objective of the speech is met. Let me share like what I liked the most in her speech. To start with, once she started, she was in a standing posture, which I loved the most because like it's more comfortable to sit where there is a camera, but she had put in efforts to set the camera and see how much she is covered. So I really appreciate her efforts on giving the speech in a standing mode and that too first speech. And then coming to like when she started, she spoke like an interview. My name is so-and-so, my parents. So I was wondering, is she in an interview? But immediately she cut down saying that I know you are bored, right? As an audience. So she knows like how the speech has to be. And it was lovely where I was about to pen down like it is like an interview, but she switched over to a storytelling mode. And that was a beautiful twist in the speech. Loved the most. And the humor was sprinkled throughout the speech, a subtle humor, like she spoke about her schooling and then permanent address. And I love this phrase which said like nomads of the 21st century. And from her entire speech, she was beautifully able to narrate her nature and talents where she studied her entire journey till now. So I know who is Vrithika. I think that is the objective of the speech and well done, Vrithika. And coming to like, see, it is not just you have written the script and you have spoken. You were able to well connect and pull the audience or pull the Toastmasters into your speech. You referred to Toastmaster Thyagarajan's speech and said that he referred to like 1,000-odd words, a lengthy speech, but yours, it is like a no word speech. That was like, and again, another reference was yesterday's Toastmaster Puneet's speech. You referred to that. And when you are pulling the audience into the speech, it is more conversational than you standing there in silo and giving a speech. Well done. And this being your icebreaker and being a new Toastmaster, I would say I don't have any recommendation at this stage. All the very best for your future speeches. Thank you. Back to you, Toastmaster, General Evaluator.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for wonderful evaluation, very crisp and clear. Now we're going for a second evaluator, Toastmaster Shiva. He's going to evaluate Toastmaster Deepak Thompson's speech. Toastmaster Shiva, please share your evaluation report.
Yeah. Thank you, General Evaluator, Toastmaster Satish. Yeah. Very good evening to all. Special mention to Deepak. Deepak, I would like to evaluate your speech in three categories. One is where you excelled at, second is recommendations, and then challenge. As you are attempting your L1 P2, you have to apply the feedback and you need to deliver the speech again. Okay. The opening was excellent. I liked that. And then you justified the title with the opening lines mentioning all the market areas and all the things. I liked that. And there is very good humorous touch in your speech. You can go for humorous speech contest in the next year or whenever you get a chance. You have good humorous touch in your speech. And the construction is also, yes, you have good construction ways and very good voice. Well, we're coming to the recommendations. The transitions can be could be better way. The transitions you transition into three parts, it could be a little bit better. And the voice modulation, it isn't flat while you are going suddenly. Or my dad said that likewise, you can change the voice modulations in between the conversation of you and your dad, or you and your friend, or ex likewise. And then the technical one, the video positioning. I don't know whether you are a bit height or the mobile, or you are using that you need to adjust before while practicing. You need to have it in handy with the camera and test it before delivering a speech. And pauses can be a bit better. Pauses while delivering your speech, the pauses can be given a bit better. And the presentation part, you get it in the last moment. So after getting a green or yellow, it would be a bit nervous or something. It became clumsy for me while observing you or presentation, both. Okay, again, the closing lines, yes, it was good. What's the challenge I want to give you is, you can play with your voice as you have a good voice modulation. Please implement this in your next, L1 P2B, the voice modulation part. And the closing part and the closing the part with realistic examples in your life. You said doctor or engineer or ex. You keep what the choices you have made in your real-time examples can give a better strength to your speech, what you given. Other than that, you excelled in your speech. Thank you. Over to General Evaluator Toastmaster Satish.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Shiva. It was a wonderful and detailed report. Thank you so much for that. And now we move on for a third speaker, speech evaluation. This speech evaluation done by our veteran Toastmaster DTM Meenanjan ma'am. DTM Meenanjan going to evaluate the DTM Ram Nelluru speech. Ma'am, please share your project report.
Thank you, General Evaluator Satish Babu, and special welcome to my guest speaker, DTM Ram. First question, when you hear a story, were you waiting to hear what happened next? I think on that single criterion, Ram passed with flying colors. Every one of us was waiting. This was a kidnapping. Who kidnapped whom? Why were they kidnapped? Your own colleague's son? Was there a ransom? Was there anything that happened? We were just glued to our chairs, waiting to see. In terms of a story, therefore, yes, great. How could we move this to the next level? One, I would think, would be in terms of structure. When I have a story, I want a context. Now, somewhere in there, we heard about your colleague's child being kidnapped. Somewhere we found about you driving a 16-seater van. Somewhere we found a van full of kids. I think if you had set the context in the beginning, my family and my colleague's family, 15 of us, were driving to see Niagara Falls. There we were traveling through the days and the nights. And this is just as we were about to reach the Niagara Falls, a police car overtook us. And then, of course, all those beautiful details you've given about the police cars coming up, your reaction, your colleague's reaction, all that tension with each thing happening here or the other. Yes, that built up the tension really, really beautifully. So I would commend that part of how you had done it. In terms of vocal variety, which is what I think you wanted me to concentrate on, I would have liked a little more modulation, because at the end, it was amazing. But that energy and that dynamism should be there throughout. So pace yourself carefully. When you have dialogue, do it a little slowly. When you have something important to say, for example, that last punchline, don't take a crying child to the bathroom, should have had a pause before it, and then it would have had more impact. As far as speaking into the computer is concerned, I suggest just look at the gallery view. Focus on at least one person who is animatedly listening to your story, and you will have that audience connect. So don't worry about speaking on Zoom. You are a great storyteller, and I'm sure we are all looking forward to many more great stories from you. Thank you for this opportunity. Back to our general evaluator.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Again, you approved that you are in a DTM. Thank you so much for your wonderful evaluation. Now we move on for our tag team report. Before moving on, I request timer to just mention the name for qualified TT speaker and along with evaluation, only for the name. Toastmaster Lakshmi Narayan.
Yeah. Am I audible?
Yes, yes.
Yes. Okay. It's you want to give, list me only the qualified people, right?
Exactly. Correct.
Okay. Okay. For the prepared speakers, all the speakers are qualified.
One second. Just to mention the name for the TP speech, who was qualified for the OT, and evaluator who was qualified for OT, not for the timing report.
Okay. For table topics, TM, I'm just letting you the name of the people who are qualified for voting. It's TM Srikanth Kotikrishnan, TM Satish, guest Harishankar, TM Punit, guest Manoj, TM Abhilash, TM Nagendra Bharati, and TM Aishwarya. For evaluation, it's TM Rekha, TM Siva, and DTM Lina Jamman.
Thank you. All the members and guests, I request you to please vote on that TT speaker along with evaluators. Now, Toastmaster Lakshmi Narayan, please read out your complete project report.
Okay. Let me scan, share my screen. Okay. Here's the report of the timer report. I think everyone has done a really great job, and there are some prepared speakers who just hit the borderlines. So to begin with, it's I'm going with the prepared speakers here. It's TM Ratika, completed by 5 minutes 36 seconds out of the 4 to 6 minutes, and TM Deepak Thompson out of 5 to 7 minutes, it's 7 minutes 30 seconds. DTM Ram Nelluru, it's 7 minutes 28 seconds. On the table topic speakers, TM Srikanth Kotikrishnan, it's 1 minute 35 seconds. TM Satish, 1 minute 6 seconds. Guest Harishankar, 1 minute 40 seconds. TM Punit, 2 minutes 25 seconds. Guest Manoj, 2 minutes 26 seconds. TM Abhilash, 1 minute 30 seconds. TM Nagendra Bharati, 2 minutes 20 seconds. TM Aishwarya, 1 minute 34 seconds, and TM Deepak Thompson, just 54 seconds. For evaluation, TM Rekha's 2 minutes 36 seconds, TM Siva, 2 minutes 50 seconds, and DTM Nina Ma'am, exactly with 3 minutes. Over to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster Lakshmi Narayan, for your detail and innovation presenting of your timer report. Thank you so much for that. And now we move on for a second R-Counter report. To share that R-Counter report, I request Toastmaster Venu Nilakandan. Toastmaster Venu Nilakandan, please share your report.
Yes. Good evening, one and all. Once again, good evening. Being the R-Counter, I am submitting my report. The presiding officer, Abhilas, Toastmaster Abhilas, was flawless. Without any R's or any repeated words or any curse words, he did an awesome job. And next, Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Geeta, she used 3++ R's, too many R's and one amps, and you know, so are repeated words. General Evaluator, Toastmaster Sadis, 3+ R's. Toast, Idiom Master, Toastmaster Aishwarya, one R's and
too many times unnecessarily used and unnecessary pass one time. Courtmaster, Toastmaster Dyagarajan, flawless. Speaker, the first speaker, Toastmaster Ratika, 1 hour, an unnecessary so and really even they are unnecessarily repeated. Speaker number two, Toastmaster Deepak, AMS 1, twice unnecessary passes, so unnecessarily used twice. Then is his favorite word, he was repeating then again and again. And speaker number three, DTM Ram, he was also flawless. Next, TT Master Kritika, she was flawless. First TT speaker, Toastmaster Srikant Kutikrishna, except one so repeated words, he never used any other crutches or arms or arms. And second speaker, TT speaker Sadish Babu, 1 hour, 1 hour. And third, Toastmaster Hari, 3+ hours. So is his favorite words. Toastmaster Puneet, 1 hour. So he used twice. Guest Manoj, 1 hour. And so twice. Toastmaster Abhilas, 1 hour. Next, Toastmaster Nagendra Bharati, 1 hour. So twice. Toastmaster Aishwarya as a TT speaker, 3+ hours. You know twice. And so like 3 times, unnecessarily used. Deepak, 1 hour. Evaluator, the first evaluator, Toastmaster Rekha, 3+ hours. 1 pass, unnecessarily used and unnecessarily used once. Toastmaster, second evaluator, Toastmaster Siva, 3+ hours, unnecessarily repeating the I twice. Third evaluator, DTM Nina, 3+ hours. And timer, Toastmaster Satyanarayana, 3+ hours. Grammarian, flawless. With that, I conclude my report, accounting report. Thank you. Back to General Evaluator Toastmaster Sadish Babu.
Thank you, Toastmaster Venu Nilakandan, for your detailed report. Thank you so much. Now we move for the report for Grammarian. I request Toastmaster Srikant Kutikrishnan to share your project report. Toastmaster Kutikrishnan, please share your project report.
Thank you, General Evaluator. Very interesting meeting. Very good usage of words. I really enjoyed listening to all the speakers. Very wonderful usage. Some really good words were used this afternoon. Let me share a few of the words that have been used. Not few, many of them. One was near-death experience. Then master our minds, blast from the past, grab the opportunity, and lesser you talk, better you listen. Eminence, posterity, verbosity, I'm hearing for the first time. Annoying, petrified, life is a matter of choices, bounty of choices. Diametrically, abandoned, ransomed, glued to our chair. These are some of the best usages that I have noted down. And the next thing is the word of the day, opportunity, was used by Deepak Thompson. Toastmaster Deepak Thompson used the word of the day twice. And a couple of suggestions where this language could be improved is, the first one is go back home, could be get back home. Life of purpose, life on purpose. And then we had a small mix up with the lighthouse ship. It should be more expressive. You should really say how you're going to make the word use lighthouse, how the lighthouse is useful for the ship to find direction. And then next is what vegetables to buy to my mom, should be what vegetables I buy for my mom. Become a mechanical engineer, should be I graduated as a mechanical engineer. Listening the music, should be listening to music. I started worrying. In the sentence, it should be used as I started to worry. Even more helpless, was I was helpless is the correct usage. Then there was transport was chopped off. It's not the right usage. It should be no means of commuting available or no means of travel is available. Wash my utensils, should be clean utensils. sitting in the home should be staying back home, then doing the business should be doing business, then a standing hope and standing mode and speaking mode is not correct. Standing or speaking is the word to be used. Only for the names should be only for names. Then finally, the one that was used is final icing in the cake should be icing on the cake. This is my detailed report. Thank you very much for the opportunity. Back to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Srikanth Gottikistan, for your wonderful grammarian report. Now, this is the time for me to submit as a General Evaluator today report. Usually, we will submit for a commendation and recommendation. Today, I will share for the CRR, which means commendation, request, and recommendation. Commendation today is for his meeting started on time. I kudos to you for Toastmaster Aishwarya. She has done a wonderful job. And second, for Toastmaster Geeta, today, as in a TMOD, she done excellent job. And especially, she has mentioned for the mom who sold the Ferrari. Ma'am, this is a really wonderful book, which I have read 1 year back. Still, I cannot forget for all the 7 major points they have mentioned in the book. You have good attempt for today. Kudos to you for that. And third is for Toastmaster Kritika. As a TT master, today she did conduct the TT session with innovative and unique topic that I should mention for unique topic. Kudos to you for Toastmaster Kritika. And request for timer. When you share about your project objective, you mentioned that when you reach the correct time, I will show you for green light, intermediate time for yellow light, and they cross for the maximum time limit, for I will show for green, red light. Instead of that, you show that green, yellow, and red signal, because that guest, they will understand whenever this green signal is displaying on the screen, they may have a clear idea who is sharing the screen. Okay, timer is sharing the screen so that the speaker are crossing the limit. So please follow that from your next meeting. It is my request. And second report is grammarian, Toastmaster Srikanth Gottikistan sir. Whenever we are conducting a meeting for, especially for the grammarian, the role we are introducing for word of the day, members should learn for the minimum one new words in the particular meeting, so that will improve for their vocabulary. The word of the day which you mentioned for today is opportunity. That is most familiar words. Everyone understand the meaning and everyone know the word very well. Instead of that, if you implement any other new words, that will help the member to learn for the new word that will improve their vocabulary. That is my request, sir. And third is for, before start our speech, all our ESCOM members, they publish in our group, in particular for CTM meeting group. Before start our meeting, please ensure that your audio and video is visible. I request everybody, please do that. And I can understand in online, we cannot avoid some technical issue, but before start your speech, please do not ask for, may I visible or my audio and video is clear. That will impact our quality of our meeting. That is my request, not by suggestion or recommendation. This is my recommendation. First thing is Toastmaster Geeta, ma'am, before introduce a general evaluator, please read out our structure of a meeting so that all the guests will understand how the meeting will carry forward. Please ensure that in our next meeting. And second is that I request all the evaluator to mention that speech timing so that guests will understand what is the time limit the speaker going to speak. Third is for TT Master, Toastmaster Kartika. I request you please avoid all the role players in TT speech, because they may be mess up. They cannot do for their role. And second thing, we should give opportunity for all the members and a guest also. Please avoid in our next meeting. I think I've taken too much of time. This is time to hand over to Toastmaster Geeta, ma'am. Hand over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Toastmaster Satish Babu. You had wonderful recommendations, and your general evaluator report was really detailed. We will make sure that we follow whatever you've told us. Thank you so much once again. With this, we come to the end of the meeting. But before we really end our meeting, what about the polls? So I request, so we'll definitely want to know who is the best speaker, who is the best role player, and who is the best tag team player. So here you have the polls right in front of you. I would like you all to vote for the best speaker. Yes, we are waiting for our next poll.
Yeah, Geeta, you can continue talking about the book if you want.
Yes, we do have it. Yeah. So this book, The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari, this is the third time I'm reading this book. But trust me, every time I pick up this book to read, I get some new understanding. So it's that amazing this book is. It has a lot of pearls of wisdom for all of us, which we can easily follow. And trust me, the book, it has beautiful stories. And it's so interesting to read that once you take hold of this book, I bet you will not put it down until you finish it. I'm reading it for the third time, but I did not get bored for a minute also. So it was that interesting. And I don't think I would have been able to do justice because with the limited time, I was not able to really bring out all the points. But this book is loaded with ample information. There's abundance in this book, which will really help us to take our lives. So with this, I hand over the control to the presiding officer, Toastmaster Abhilash, to take the meeting further. Yes, we do have another poll also. Do vote for the best evaluator as well. Over to you, Toastmaster Abhilash.
Thank you, Toastmaster Rekha. Sorry, thank you, Toastmaster Geeta, for having had such a wonderful team and having conducted the meeting. It is now time for us to hear from the guests. But before that, as per tradition, we have had an excellent icebreaker today. And so I would request you all to unmute yourselves and give a standing ovation to Toastmaster Ratika, who delivered her icebreaker today. Thank you, everyone. So now, let us move on to the guest feedback. We have a number of guests with us today. First on, let us hear from our guest evaluator, Toastmaster Shiva.
Hi, Abhilash. Toastmaster Abhilash. Good evening. It was nice meeting conducted today. Meeting a couple of DTMs, that Nina John ma'am, all this veteran Toastmasters more than our club. So it was great meeting you people and good speeches. Even the icebreaker one was very good. The one Ram delivered a story was, it's also nice. The one Deepak, learned each lesson from each the speaker. So everyone good, done their best and the student at top. Yeah, it was nice learning for me also. It was in second time I'm evaluating a speaker. So for me is also it's a learning how to evaluate and how to observe the things what others observe. So yeah, again the Geeta ma'am pick a very very good topic by a book by Robin Sharma. It creates interest to me to read that book. So yep, it was nice. Thank you.
Great. So thank you. Now, can we have guest Nunalini? Let us hear from her. Chill. I think she might have some issue. Let's move on. Akhilesh, are you here?
Yes, I'm here.
How did you feel the meeting was today? How did it
go? Yeah, the meeting was very good.
Great. Thank you, Akhilesh. Yes, Harishankar. Sir, you're on mute, sir. Please.
The meeting went well, and looking forward to join the club again.
Great, sir. Always a pleasure to have you back. And so I think now that we are done with this, let's move on to the results for the day. So the best quote idiom master for today is the idiom master, Toastmaster Aishwarya. A big round of applause, please. The next thing, the best stat player, the timer, art counter, and the grammarian goes to our grammarian, Toastmaster Srikanth Kuttikrishnan. Please give a huge round of applause. The best role player for today among the TT Master, the TS Toastmaster of the day, and the general evaluator. Today, the best role player goes to the TT Master, Toastmaster. Huge round of applause. The best evaluator for the day goes to DTM Nina John. A huge round of applause for DTM Nina John. Moving on, the last but one, the best TT speaker for today. The best TT speaker for today is Toastmaster Nagendra Bharati. A huge round of applause for Toastmaster Nagendra Bharati. And the last but not the least, the best speaker for today is DTM Ram. A huge round of applause to DTM Ram. And so with this, I adjourn meeting number 747 to next week, Sunday, same time, 4 to 6 through Zoom. Sergeant Dhanam, request you to stop the recording and you can have the unofficial.